Crash course on 9/11 American terrorist attacks. Why did Osama bin Laden want to destroy USA? On September 11, 2001, the United States suffered the deadliest terrorist attack in its history. 19 hijackers associated with the Islamic extremist group Al-Qaeda carried out 4 coordinated attacks, targeting the World Trade Center in New York City and the Pentagon in Washington, D.C., resulting in the deaths of nearly 3,000 people. The mastermind behind the attacks was Osama bin Laden, the founder of Al-Qaeda. Bin Laden had long harbored a deep hatred for the United States, dating back to the 1980s when the U.S. provided support to Afghan rebels fighting against the Soviet Union. Bin Laden saw the U.S. as a corrupt and imperialist power, seeking to exploit and dominate Muslim countries. Over the years, bin Laden became increasingly radicalized, advocating for violent jihad against the West. He believed that the U.S. was the primary obstacle to the establishment of a global Islamic caliphate, and that only through violent attacks could the Muslim world rid itself of American influence. Bin Laden first attempted to attack the U.S. in 1993, when a bomb was detonated in the parking garage of the World Trade Center, killing 6 people and injuring over 1,000. Bin Laden viewed this attack as a failure, and vowed to carry out a larger, more devastating attack in the future. The 9/11 attacks were the culmination of bin Laden's plan to strike the U.S. in a spectacular and deadly way. The hijackers trained for months in Al-Qaeda camps in Afghanistan, learning how to fly commercial airliners and practicing their suicide missions. On the morning of September 11, 2001, the hijackers took control of 4 planes, with 2 crashing into the twin towers of the World Trade Center, 1 crashing into the Pentagon, and another crashing into a field in Pennsylvania after passengers attempted to overpower the hijackers. The attacks sent shockwaves throughout the world, leading to a massive global effort to track down and dismantle Al-Qaeda and other terrorist organizations. Bin Laden was eventually located and killed by U.S. Special Forces in Pakistan in 2011, but the threat of terrorism remains a pressing concern for the U.S. and the world. One of the most remarkable stories to come out of the 9/11 attacks is the heroism of the first responders who rushed into the burning buildings to rescue as many people as they could. Firefighters, police officers, and other emergency personnel risked their lives to save others, with many losing their lives in the process. Another inspiring story is that of the passengers on United Airlines Flight 93, who learned of the other attacks through phone calls and decided to attempt to overpower the hijackers. The plane crashed into a field in Pennsylvania, but the actions of the passengers likely saved countless lives by preventing the hijackers from reaching their intended target. The attacks of 9/11 changed the world in many ways, leading to a massive increase in security measures and an ongoing struggle against terrorism. The legacy of the attacks, however, is not just one of destruction and fear, but also one of resilience and heroism in the face of tragedy. In the aftermath of the attacks, the United States launched a global war on terror, with a particular focus on rooting out Al-Qaeda and other terrorist organizations. The U.S. invaded Afghanistan, where the Taliban government had provided safe haven to Al-Qaeda, and launched a massive drone campaign to target suspected terrorists in countries such as Pakistan and Yemen. The attacks also had far-reaching effects on American society, with a significant increase in surveillance and security measures in airports, public buildings, and other public spaces. The U.S. also passed the controversial Patriot Act, which expanded the government's ability to conduct surveillance and detain suspected terrorists. The attacks of 9/11 also had significant effects on American culture and politics, with a sharp increase in anti-Muslim sentiment and a growing polarization between conservative and liberal viewpoints. The war on terror became a major issue in American politics, with debates over the efficacy and morality of U.S. foreign policy. Despite the challenges posed by the attacks, the U.S. has shown remarkable resilience in the face of adversity. The country has continued to thrive and innovate, with advancements in technology, medicine, and other fields. The spirit of the American people, as exemplified by the heroism of the first responders and ordinary citizens on 9/11, remains strong and unwavering. One final story that exemplifies the resilience and hope of the American people is the story of the 9/11 Memorial and Museum, which was built on the site of the World Trade Center. The memorial features 2 reflecting pools, each with the names of the nearly 3,000 victims engraved along the edges, and a museum that tells the story of the attacks and their aftermath. The memorial has become a symbol of remembrance and resilience, honoring the memory of those who were lost while inspiring hope for a better future. Here are top 10 facts, stories about Osama bin Laden. Osama bin Laden was born in 1957 in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, into a wealthy and influential family. His father was a billionaire construction magnate who had close ties to the Saudi royal family. Bin Laden became involved in the Afghan resistance movement against Soviet occupation in the 1980s, where he helped to recruit and train foreign fighters, including Arab volunteers who would later form the core of Al-Qaeda. Bin Laden's radical ideology and opposition to Western influence were influenced by the teachings of radical Islamist thinkers such as Saeed Qutbi and Abdullah Azzam. Bin Laden founded Al-Qaeda in 1988, with the goal of waging a global jihad against the United States and other Western powers. The group was responsible for a series of terrorist attacks around the world, including the 1998 bombings of the U.S. embassies in Kenya and Tanzania, and the 2000 bombing of the USS Cole in Yemen. Bin Laden was accused of masterminding the 9/11 attacks, which resulted in the deaths of nearly 3,000 people. He initially denied responsibility, but later claimed that the attacks were carried out in retaliation for U.S. policies in the Middle East, particularly its support for Israel and military presence in Saudi Arabia. Following the 9/11 attacks, the U.S. launched a global manhunt for bin Laden. He went into hiding, and was believed to be hiding in the mountainous border region between Pakistan and Afghanistan. Bin Laden was killed in a U.S. raid on his compound in Abbottabad, Pakistan, on May 2, 2011. The raid was carried out by a team of U.S. Navy SEALs, who shot and killed bin Laden after a brief firefight. Bin Laden's death was a significant blow to Al-Qaeda, but the group has continued to operate and carry out attacks around the world. Bin Laden's personal life was shrouded in mystery, but he was known to have multiple wives and dozens of children. His youngest wife and several of his children were present in the Abbottabad compound at the time of the raid. Bin Laden remains a controversial figure, with some hailing him as a hero and martyr in the fight against Western imperialism, while others view him as a ruthless terrorist who committed atrocities in the name of a twisted ideology. His legacy continues to inspire and influence extremist groups around the world. In conclusion, the attacks of 9/11 were a tragic and devastating event that shook the world and changed the course of history. The reasons behind the attacks, as well as the heroism and resilience of those who responded to them, continue to inspire reflection and debate. As we remember those who were lost on that fateful day, we also look towards a future of hope and progress, united in our determination to overcome adversity and build a better world. Here is a poem about 9/11 attacks and consequences. Towers of steel, soaring high. Symbols of freedom, reaching for the sky. But on that fateful September day, terror struck in the most horrific way. The planes, hijacked by terrorists' hands, became weapons of destruction, shattering our lands. The Twin Towers fell, a nation in shock. Smoke and debris filling the streets, around the clock. The Pentagon, too, was hit in a deadly blow. And in Pennsylvania, a plane was brought low. The loss of life, the tragedy and pain. It felt like the end, an unbreakable chain. But in the midst of the chaos, a hero arose. A nation united, against a common foe. First responders, firefighters, and police risked their lives with courage and grace. In the aftermath, the world was changed. The fight against terror, fiercely engaged. New security measures, and heightened fears. The nation banding together, to shed new tears. The memory of that day, will never fade. A wound on the heart, that can never be swayed. But in the darkness, a light still shines. A spirit of resilience, that forever defines. The nation rebuilt, with a steadfast heart. A symbol of hope, that will never depart. And though the wounds may never fully heal, we rise again, with a strength that's real. *** Start planning your next global adventure with ease and convenience with our Booking.com referral link. https://www.booking.com/index.html?aid=798-9335 is a great choice to plan your next trip. You can find and book flights, hotels, cars, and local attractions all in one place, and their price match guarantee ensures you're getting the best deal. Thank you for kind support our AnHub Metaverse channel, and please watch more interesting videos here.